Hi everybody, this is Kevin Bailey with DB Services, and today I'm going to show you how to integrate FileMaker and Adobe InDesign to help you save time and money by automating repetitive tasks that you might do over and over again and get you headed down the right path. I'm going to show you our free way of doing it, you know, by creating just a little bit of XML and also with using a little bit of JavaScript as the video goes on. And then towards the end of the video, I'm going to show you a couple third-party products that can help you do the same thing. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is make sure you have Adobe InDesign set up. You're all signed in and everything. And then the next two things are just creating a folder to export the XML that we're going to be creating in this video. And then also a folder to import the, or to export rather, the images that we'll be using as well. And I've done that right here. I've got my folder for my XML to be exported into. And then this is for the images. Now, we can just go ahead and get started by going to the example. So what we're going to do in this video is really just show you how to set up, in this case, a magazine that might have pages that look similar that we are just going to keep repeating over and over again. So we're going to use some templates to kind of show you how this works. So let's go ahead and create the publication. We'll call this our DB Services Magazine. And we'll add a few pages. Now, like I said, I've made some templates here that we can go ahead and use for this video. The templates that you could make could be much more complex than what I've done, but to save us a little bit of time, I've just made four here that I'll show you now. The first one I've made is just a full page ad, and here we can just throw in, I've got some test images here that I'm just going to drag right in there. Oh, come on. And there's our first page. Now the second page, this is for if you are often making half page articles with half page ads. So we'll go ahead and create an ad here. It's going to be on the bottom half of this page. And then we'll add an article. Now for this, I'm just going to use some classic lorem ipsum to save us a little bit of time for this video. I'll just copy this here. Okay, and then I'll add another page with the ad on the top. Same thing here, I'll just dump an image into this, and we'll add some more lorem ipsum. Okay, and then for the last page, I'll just make a full page article. And we'll just use all of the lorem ipsum I've created here. Okay, so now we have four pages set up for this article, or for this publication rather. And you know, if you wanted to add more pages, you could, just using these same templates. We'll show you how those work. So I'm going to add my export path here. Like I said, we'll be using the InDesign folder for the XML and the images folder for the images. And all you have to do is click Create XML, and there you have it. We have our XML here to see, so you can look at it there, but also in our folder, it's exported directly right there with our images following. Now, we can go into InDesign and show you how the magic actually works. All you have to do, and it's very simple, is open up a InDesign template here. This is one that I have, just a couple pages. And you click File, then Import XML. And then you just double-click on the XML you want to import, click OK, and there you have it. You now have all your articles, your images, everything you need. And you can drag that in, and you can drag in your articles, and have everything just kind of manually set wherever you want to set it, which is fine. You can go ahead and resize things, move things around, place them wherever you want. But for just a little bit more of the automation that we talked about earlier, you can click on your JavaScript that you've created. Now, I've created JavaScript in here that basically all it does is it identifies the page that it's looking for with certain coordinates to place the items. So we have our templates, as you can see, half page ad, half page ad. And then it also has it set up to position the items wherever they need to be. Now, we've pre-planned this, and like I said, you can make this much more complicated than it is, or much more complex, rather, and really set up super interesting templates if you think you're going to use them over and over again. But again, I just made a few simple ones here. But with this JavaScript, all you need to do is double-click it. And what it does is it creates those pages for you, and it adds the images, the articles, whatever you need, where they need to be. So you see here, this template's taken care of. This other one is taken care of. And really, once it's in there, you can do some fine-tuning as well. You could go in and resize images, shape things however you want them. You could, minimize the amount of height that you're using for each article. But the idea is that it just kind of places them wherever you want and saves you time in the long run by quickly creating these pages. Now, like I said earlier in the video, I do want to show you a couple things real quick. There is some third-party products that we've seen that people might be interested in using. They aren't free, but they do come with a free trial. And the first of these is Easy Catalog by 65bit. Now, basically, what this does is it keeps everything up to date with your FileMaker database. So everything that you have in there can dynamically be adjusted in InDesign just by linking your InDesign or with your FileMaker database. It keeps everything up to date. It is easy to use, and basically it's just an extra plugin that you can use to make sure that the templates that you create are constantly up to date. If things are changing, if you constantly have new SKU numbers or whatever it might be in your FileMaker database, this will keep everything up to date for you. And similarly, we have M Software, which has InData and XData. And this is kind of the same thing, except the difference here is that this uses placeholder text, much like we use our merge fields. It lets you use placeholders with just a couple brackets on either side, like this, to save a spot for your data to be entered. So then all you have to do is run this program, and it just dumps in all your information into those placeholder fields, and again, just saves you a ton of time and keeps everything up to date and very accurate. So that's pretty much everything. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day.